My name is Carlos, and today I'll show you how to send After Effects renders over the internet. If you are wondering why render remotely, there are a few scenarios in which this has been useful to me. If you just want the instructions, you can skip ahead to this timecode in the video. The first scenario is sending renders to one or more virtual machines. Sometimes for really heavy projects, it can be faster to send a render to the cloud, either as a studio that rents a lot of machines or as a single artist. For example, if you have only one computer, you could send a render to the cloud. That way you can keep working while the render is happening on that virtual machine. And I know render time is really nice for breaks, but not when it's going to take hours and hours and you're at a deadline. You can rent one or more virtual machines from services like AWS, Paperspace, ShadowTech, etc., and create a personal render farm on the web. I've done this for a few projects, and it's also really nice that those services have really fast internet because they're in a data center. So if you render on those machines, it's really fast to upload to Vimeo, YouTube, Frame.io, etc., much faster than it would be if you uploaded from your own machine. The second scenario is working with remote artists. A lot of times, I work with artists in different parts of the world. And if their internet speed is not that great, it can be faster for them to send renders here or to one of the cloud services mentioned before. The reason is that when you send a remote render, you only need to transfer the After Effects file project and not the finished render files, which are often like ProRes 444 or DPX sequences, etc. So they're usually much larger than just the project file. Especially if you have a lot of long shots or just a lot of shots in general. And when you're in a short deadline, waiting for the transfer of those big files can be the difference between delivering on time or being late. And it's also really stressful. The last scenario is working on the go. And I know this is probably the least common, like the one that's gonna be the least useful to most people, but I used it a while back when RenderBoss was just like a scrawny little prototype. And I was working on my short film Nexus, but you know, sometimes I had to be on set for another job. And often you're not needed for long periods of time, so I brought my laptop to work on some shots of my film, and when it came time to render out, I could just send them to my main machine at home, which was faster and also didn't use my battery, and that allowed me to keep working on my laptop. Sometimes it was also nice to go out and work from a coffee shop, and I could send the renders home before leaving the coffee shop, and by the time I got back, they were done. And that's it. Let's get into it. You'll need After Effects with RenderBoss, of course, and make sure all the computers have the same version of After Effects installed, including plugins and fonts. You'll also need a cloud syncing service like Dropbox or Google Drive, etc. I recommend Dropbox because of the ones that we tested, that was the fastest one, and we also made certain optimizations for it. But you can use any service as long as it has enough space. You will need to have the whole project and all its files synchronized in both machines. If you're using Dropbox, for example, that means to make sure that all the files needed for the project are, you know, somewhere inside the Dropbox folder. I know projects can be huge, so make sure you give them enough time to synchronize. All right, so let's set RenderBoss for remote rendering. You only have to do this the first time. There are two ways, but the easiest one is by using the multi-machine assistant. Go to multiple threads and machines, then set multiple machine renders. Since this is the first computer I'm setting, I'll select that. I'm using a file syncing service, which is like Dropbox, Google Drive, etc. So I'll select that. And then I need to enter a location for the work folder. This has to be inside your file syncing folder. Like in this case, I'm using Dropbox. So I'll select my Dropbox folder and it will automatically create a folder inside. I'll click next. And that's it for this machine. That's just the information about my folder, so I'll click finish, and now I'll move on to my next machine. All right, so now I'm in the remote machine. In this case, I'm connected remotely to a virtual machine on Paperspace. But of course, this can be your laptop, home machine, or a beefed up workstation at the office. It could also be a cluster of machines in AWS or Paperspace or whatever other service. Anyway, I'll open the multi-machine assistant and I'll click that this is an additional machine. Then I'll check that I'm using a file syncing service, just like I did on the first machine. Now I will find inside Dropbox the folder that I assigned on my first machine. Now I click next and that's kind of it. If I go to the machines tab, you can see that this machine is now on the list. And by the way, you can always tell which machine you're on because the name of your current machine shows up on the title bar.
Anyway, I'll close this. And this is my main workstation at home. And this is the paper space machine, which is paused right now. So let's turn auto start on. That way, when I send a render to it, it will start automatically. And that's it. This machine is ready. Let's go back to my machine and send a render. This is the comp I want to render, and it's from my very, very silly Tesla Autopilot racing video. I'm going to add it to the render queue, and I'll place my output inside Dropbox. And this is my own folder structure, but it doesn't really matter where you put it, as long as it's inside the same folder service where your project is. So in my case, I can place this in any folder inside Dropbox. All right, so I'll click save. Since I want to render on the Paperspace machine, I'll go to the render bus extension, then the tab called target. And by default, this will be set to all local machines. But since that's not what I want, I'll click this. And here I will select the remote machine. If I had several machines connected remotely, I could select this option, include target's local network, and all the machines that are in the same network as the target would start rendering. For more information about setting that up, go to the documentation. There's a link in the description. For now, since I only have one machine, it doesn't really matter. So I'll just click send to render boss. Now, if I go back to render boss, you can see that this job was skipped on this machine because the target is, well, is that other machine, the Paperspace machine. If I go to Paperspace, you'll see that it's just starting to render. If it doesn't start right away, don't panic. It does have to transfer the render boss info, which is a tiny file, plus a copy of your project. So it might take a minute to show up depending on how big your project is. In this case, I'm looking at the Paperspace machine remotely, but you don't really need remote access to control or monitor your renders. If I go back to my main machine, you can see that it tells me that it's rendering on the other machine. And in time, it will also tell me the progress and estimated time to finish. And if I want to stop it or anything, I can still do it from here just by right-clicking and selecting the appropriate option. And all right, it looks like the render finished. I got the notification down here and the status changed to success. Since the output file is inside Dropbox, it should synchronize and I should be able to open it from here. It's small enough, so it might be done already. Yep. And here it is, my finished render. Still as ridiculous as I remember it. Cool.
And that's it. Make sure you take a look at the links in the description if you need more information. Otherwise, I hope that was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.